Today's episode is brought to you by Harry's. Please visit harrys.com and enter code CAG at checkout to claim your free trial set and free post-shave balm. That's harrys.com, code CAG. CAGcast episode number 484. I'm your host, GBD, here in Long Island, New York. And as always, we are joined by a man who wants nothing more in life than a bottle of Big Mac sauce, Wombat.
I'm really like tempted to try to do it tomorrow. I know what time to be there.
Oh, there's a thing that you can do to get
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's like a thing. It's close by to my office and it's at a time that kind of works. But well, then there's the me going to McDonald's to get a bottle of Big Mac sauce angle that I don't know if I really need to do that. But
what do you have to do to get it? Like, what's the thing?
So you really don't have to do much. You go to McDonald's, you place your order, and then there's you have to say like a special phrase. Uh-huh. I think it's like a there's a Big Mac for that or something. I believe I have it on my phone somewhere. And if you say that, if you're one of the first 10,000 people to do it or so, they give you a bottle.
How do
they
know?
The worker goes, Jesus, it's one of these guys.
Yeah. Yep. And then they'll probably look at you and go, oh, I'm sorry, you're too late. And then I weep.
What time do you have to do it by? Like, I don't understand.
Well, they started at around noon.
What if, it doesn't make any sense. How would they know? I don't know. I guess it's like 10,000 orders.
I think it's 10,000 nationally though. So I don't know how many my McDonald's is going to get.
Right. One.
Yeah. Exactly. So, I don't know.
You better beg on Twitter. That's your best chance. I saw that.
That's what I was trying to do.
Well, I saw that Jason from Howard Stern Show got one.
Well, see?
They just sent him one, and he said he was really excited about it.
I'm not cool enough.
And he's going to keep
it. I should be cool enough, but I'm not cool enough.
He's going to keep it in a refrigerated case.
I like how this is apparently the biggest news of the day for you. there's bigger news.
Oh, yeah.
There's bigger news.
Shipwreck made it another person.
That's right. Congratulations, Mr. Shipwreck, on your new person.
Yes.
Thank you. I'm enjoying my new person.
Are you?
This one has a penis.
Congratulations.
Upgrade.
I don't know if that's an upgrade. It's just
next gen.
Oh. Yes, I am extremely tired because it's been, I don't know, 5 days? We had the baby on Saturday. And I don't know what day it is.
It's Thursday night.
It's not Thursday night. It's Wednesday night.
It's Wednesday.
That's okay.
Night. See, I'm trying to confuse them. We could really fuck them up.
That would not take much. Yeah. Yes. I went to Target. Like we got dismissed from the hospital pretty quickly. Like we came home Monday afternoon, and so. You have to do like that immediate Target run to get all the baby stuff that you didn't expect to need.
Right.
Because this baby came early, mm-hmm. like 3 weeks early, not as early as my last one, but, so yeah, I went to Target and I had a list of like four things to get. It took me like an hour of just standing there looking at the list and then looking at the shelves and going, I don't know what I'm supposed to do here.
Like, didn't you do this already?
Oh, what do you mean?
What do you mean you didn't know what to do?
No. What I was like, I was so out of it at Target when I was like looking at the shelf.
I understand that.
Got it.
Yeah. I was just like in a stupor looking at the shelf. And then I got distracted by the 132 copies of Garth Brooks box set they had on clearance.
I saw that. Did you get me one? Because I could use a clear box set. I'm kidding, by the way.
Oh, don't man. Get him. That made me laugh. I will. What was Target thinking there? Like
everyone loves Garth Brooks. Right? He's so relevant.
Everybody loves CDs. They're so relevant.
Yeah, saying that too. Yeah,
but yeah, my kid's name is Dashiell.
It's a good name. Strong name.
Cool. Masculine name.
My my wife and I were both impressed that there are now two people in your house named after Incredibles.
Are there?
Yeah.
What's
there is a Bob and there is a Dash.
I guess so. I didn't make the connection with the Bob.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So congratulations.
Thanks. We have two Incredibles.
Congratulations on being a Bob.
Right.
Well, you know, it's close enough. Robert.
Yeah. Everything's good though. Gretchen's doing fine. I'm doing fine. Baby's doing fine. Emmeline's doing fine.
Is she holding up? Is she accepting?
She is great. Yes. She wants to, like, she likes to sing him songs constantly and like read him books and do all that Perfect. Big sister stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah. She was ready. She somehow knew what was coming.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. She's pretty smart. So she's got it under control.
Welcome.
She'll be babysitting.
Welcome to the two kid club.
Thanks.
You no longer outnumber them.
Nope. No.
All right.
Emmeline kind of outnumbered us already, so it doesn't seem
different.
That bad.
Trust me, it's different.
Now you're really screwed, is what he's saying. Get ready to be outnumbered twice.
you kind of get to ease into it in the sense that, you know, he's not walking yet. But once you got two walkers and talkers, it's a whole different set of bananas.
Bananas.
But it's a good set of bananas.
So if I just doze off and like just sleep on my microphone about halfway through this episode, that's the other thing,
though. I mean, at least in time, you'll get to sleep again. That does end.
This one seems better than the first time around. You're really not prepared for it.
No.
Like, nobody tells you these things that need to get fed every 2 hours. And
someone's going to, you both be awake anyway.
Right. You're both going to be awake doing that, because even if you're not the one feeding it, you are the one cleaning the stuff involved with it, or some measure of this takes a second person.
Yes.
I remember the first time I was home alone with Sabrina and being scared to death, and then, you know, jump ahead to being left alone with Elliot and Sabrina for the first time, and it's like nothing. Right. So, yeah, it's definitely, you know, it's not this so much that it's easier as much as it is, you know, you've experienced it. So there's a little bit of, you kind of know what you're doing a little bit better.
Exactly. You'll be good to go. Mm-hmm. I don't think he's worried.
Yeah. I was.
He just wants to be awake.
Either.
That's all.
Yeah, that's not going to happen.
Have you guys, I wanted to ask you this question. Have you guys found yourself shopping at Best Buy a lot more now that you're constantly buying games from them, from the Gamers Club? Because I found myself buying weird stuff from them now that you wouldn't expect to buy at Best Buy.
Huh. I will go there. Like, if it's a similar priced item, I will check there. Definitely. If it's something that Best Buy carries,
I tend to lean more towards Target for non video game related items for two reasons. One, it's closer to my house.
I'm talking about online, mainly, but.
But like what though?
I found they do like these deals of the day. So I bought these pitchers like that go in your refrigerator, you know, for to put iced tea in. They sell these Japanese like pitchers that you can put on the side, you know, if you don't have a big fridge so you can't fit it straight up. So, like, stuff like that I would normally buy from Amazon, I find myself just buying at Best Buy now because I get the rewards points and I know I'm going to be buying games from them anyway because of the 20% off. But I noticed they don't have the $10 pre-order bonuses anymore. Like, no games.
I'm sure something will come back usually by this summer. That's my guess.
Yeah, that was sort of disappointing. Anyway.
I'm disappointed that Mass Effect isn't on there, but
there's nothing. Literally, nothing is on there. I just checked yesterday.
I know, but I'm just saying. Like, I thought Mass Effect would be on there.
Right, it's got to be. Get something on there. Anyway, so I bought like this face cleaning brush. Have you seen this? It was on a deal of the day, and it's like a...
I have not seen this. What is a face cleaning
what
brush?
Is it? What is
it's
it?
It's motorized.
Okay.
Is it like a little handheld thing?
Yes.
With a little circular
yes.
brush?
Yes, yes, yes.
I have one.
You do?
I have
it's called a toothbrush.
No. It's
you
from
put that
no,
in your mouth.
In your face.
It's like, I'm going to say...
Right in your mouth hole.
Like maybe what, like 3 or 4 inches in diameter?
Yeah.
Or so? And it's a circle.
Yes.
And it's got brushes and yeah. It spins and you use it to wash your
face.
It's
called like the Tao face brush or something. Anyway, it was like...
I don't know. I have one that I got as a gift.
Do you never use it?
I use it occasionally. It's in the shower.
Oh. It's supposed to be good because it was $80 on the deal of the day. And I saw...
Wow, that's expensive.
So hold on. So like I'll tell you, like I have bad complexion. So I figured I would give this a try. The reviews were, I looked on Amazon. The reviews were
I've
really
known
good.
You for 12 years. Your complexion is
You
fine.
Can't even see my face. You're so far away from me. Just.
Oh, is that what it is? So now you're making a short joke?
Yes.
Thanks.
It's not so much a short joke as it is a tall joke as well. Why is it so great to be tall? Why do people think that it's like, oh, you know, it's bad to be short and great to be tall? I don't think that's the case. I'm sure you find it to be advantageous plenty of times being shorter, right?
No, never.
Sitting on an airplane, you don't think it's like better to be like...
I guess.
You guess?
I guess.
What do you mean?
The one time of a year I'm on an airplane, yeah, that's totally worth it.
Well, it'd be worth it. What's the downside?
I don't know. Pants. Buying pants is tough.
Oh, it's the thing it's easy for tall people?
Yes.
Well, pants is not that bad, actually. But everything else is bad. Pants are okay.
Shirts. Shirts are all too long.
Okay. Well, shorts are all too short for tall people.
Uh-huh.
And now everything's...
I like being a medium-sized person.
That's the way to go.
You're the winner right there.
That's definitely the
way. You have red hair, so you know, we all lose some way.
Anyway, I haven't used the face brush yet, but I'll report back to you next week. It's charging right now.
I am positive this is going to be worth your $80.
It looks so cool, though. You Google here. Google. I think it's called Tao face brush. Let's see. No, maybe not. No, Tao Clean.
I really want to pretend
Tao
that
Clean.
I care.
TaoClean.com. You'll see. Just look at it. Look
really
at it.
Care.
Just look at it. It looks like it's from another
T-A-O
planet.
T-A-O Clean?
Yes. Look at this thing. And tell me it doesn't look cool.
Tao Clean.
Yeah, come on.
Oh, yeah. That's definitely different than mine.
Oh, that looks cool,
mine
though.
Doesn't have like a, mine doesn't have like a basin that it sits in.
Right, and a space light?
And a space light. Mine is really just the brush with the button. To
right.
Spin.
You would not probably pay $80 for that, but.
No, I would not.
It was supposed to be, it was normally $200.
You know what else I can wash my face with? My hands.
I don't do a good job, I find. I'm trying to get into...
You don't do a good job as a consumer either, it seems.
Well, I'll let you know next week.
Please.
If all my pimples are gone by next week, then...
This thing looks enormous.
It's not that big. It just looks like that because it's a
It looks
space
like it's
light.
Like a 6-inch diameter base that this thing has.
It's maybe 5 inches or 6. I got a lot of room on the counter there anyway. The only thing on there is my toothbrush.
Base measures 4.9 inches.
There you go. See? Tiny. I'm going to get another one so I can go two-handed. Well, we'll see. I also bought a keyboard so I can start my dance music career. Dance music producing
career.
Oh, a
music keyboard.
Yeah. Yes, a music keyboard. Did you know that you can now have a MIDI keyboard and you don't have to have MIDI cables? They just plug in USB right into a computer. Technology.
I can't wait to hear your crappy original intros to the show.
Yeah, if only this thing came with this software called Ableton. It's probably easier to learn Chinese, I'm thinking. So I may try to do that.
How many different versions of Axel F are you planning to play?
0.
Boop, 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 boop.
It's pretty exciting.
Waka waka.
Anyway, you know what else is exciting?
What?
Show feedback.
Woo!
People really liked the show last week, it looks like.
They did. Actually, it was a very well-received show. and the comments were all really even-handed, and I really liked them. So thank you, everybody. Seth Mason had to say, I'll be honest, I fully expected 90 minutes of shitting on Switch. Of all the critical Switch talk I've seen and heard online since the reveal, you guys had the most even-handed. It wasn't glowing fanboyism or too cool for school cynicism. Great show. Mm. Codename Lenny had to say, I mostly agree with your Switch presentation discussion. It was very disappointed, and I also ended up pre-ordering one. I don't think we could take their word about the Switch not being a DS 3DS replacement. When the DS came out, they said the same thing about the Game Boy, and they never released another. By your Bardia 27 said, I think you had a more nuanced discussion of Nintendo compared to past shows. It was a more positive take than expected. Yeah, very positive feedback on our Switch talk. Do you have any updates, anything you want to add about the Switch? new thoughts?
I spent so much time thinking about the Switch before last week's show that I don't think I thought about video games at all between then and now, because I was just tired of thinking about video games. I'm not even joking. I'm really not joking.
I believe you. And I'm serious.
I believe that Shipwreck feels the same way, except he had a baby somewhere in the middle.
Right. So. Like somewhere in there, the Switch completely went away in my mind.
Exactly.
Like, until today when I tried to pre-order a Pro Controller and they were all sold out.
Yes, well.
Yeah, I will say, just to comment on this guy's comment, you definitely cannot go by what Nintendo PR has decided you're going to hear. You know, they're not going to tell you anything's going to be a replacement for something. They're going to keep selling those 3DSs until they can't sell them anymore. And
they just announced a new version of it.
I know, of course, because they're going to not make that many.
Sold out version of it. Is that thing.
How much? It's $200, right?
It doesn't matter. Yeah. Did you see how cute that Pikachu is on the front of that thing?
I know. No, I'm not saying it's a lot. I'm saying that's like a nice, probably nice profit for them in there. That's a nice markup, yeah. I'm saying. And they're going to sell out of them anyway. So they should probably make a lot. But I guess they won't.
Exactly.
Yeah, I was going to say that, I think that the Switch is definitely going to be their portable. The platform, they're going to talk, they always talk about the Switch platform, right? Yeah, I mean, that's what's going to happen. It's just really a matter of time. But they'll continue to sell the 3DS until nobody's buying them. But when you got people like...
I don't necessarily agree with that still, but...
Okay, but look, because
there's something new. Whether it's... I don't think it's just the Switch.
I'm saying the Switch platform. Maybe it's... Switch platform, right? They can call it something else.
Something else. A Switch U might come out.
Switch up. How about they call it Switch up? Switch off?
The Switch DS with one screen. I don't know. There's going to be a separate, at least, form factor.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I'm just talking about like the operating system, the platform. You can build whatever plastic goes around it. That really doesn't matter.
And let's see if we want this platform to begin with.
Exactly. Exactly. But I think that's the plan. That's really Nintendo's plan.
The reason I can't completely buy into that is that this thing is so reactionary to the Wii U taking so hard that I don't know if they have the plan in place that far beyond. Let's get something else out there.
Right. That's true. They certainly can just be playing it as it goes, right? They don't have to go start making a more portable Switch right now. They can take their time and see how this thing does and go from there. You know? Anything else here, Wombat?
Yeah. Has to say, Wombat's reptile dysfunction comment needs to be commended. Did none of the other hosts hear that one? They're in the presence of a comedy genius and not even a snicker. Jeez,
you're
guys,
really
going
to bring
seriously.
Up your joke again to hope that we laugh at it.
Yes. I'll be perfectly honest. It's the most comments I got on Twitter from a joke I think ever in the history of the show was that one stupid joke that I made.
Well, it's certainly possible that I did not. I can't speak for Shipwreck, but
I heard it.
Okay, I don't
he
remember.
Just chose not to laugh.
I don't remember if I heard it or not. I can't really say either way. But yeah, it's that's very clever, Wombat. Let me applaud right now.
Thank you. This is what I wanted. Thank you. my penis already feels bigger. I appreciate
it. This is what he came for. All right. How about some watch this, bitches?
Sure. What are you watching?
I'm still watching the Young Pope. It's very good. I'm hooked. It's like I said, it's pretty trippy. I like shows that are different, and this is pretty different. So I think you should check it out. Don't you have HBO?
Yes.
Just watch one episode. It's fun.
All right.
You're not gonna watch it.
No, I'm not. I'll say all right.
Instead of just flipping around the TV and seeing what garbage is on, or watching,
I have like a whole backlog of shows now to watch.
Lucifer, at least.
I have to get through Supergirl.
It's good.
Flash.
That's also good. We're watching the January episodes. They're very good.
Mm-hmm.
Who saw Storks? Ship.
I saw Storks.
My kids like that movie. What'd you think?
I thought it was actually a lot better than what I would have predicted.
Really?
Yeah. It's a funny like kids movie. It's really not that bad.
Hmm.
And I picked it up. It was $10 for the Blu-ray at Target this week.
Oh, you went to get part of that Target sale?
I was at Target and it was there, so I don't know what you mean, but yes.
They're having a big sale on DVDs and Blu-rays for $10.
Okay. Yes, I went to Target and purchased this for $10 because I saw that it had babies on it, and my daughter has been wanting to watch anything that involves babies in all of her...
Why?
I have no idea. So there's some clever stuff in Storks, though.
It's got to be better.
It's weird that movie got made, but they did all right.
I watched Alice Through the Looking Glass over the weekend.
That's not
You don't need to see that.
That's not supposed to be very good.
It wasn't. It was quite the disappointment.
That's a movie I would watch on an airplane.
It's a movie I watched because Sabrina really wanted to watch it, so we watched it as a family.
Mm.
Yeah, that's the right answer.
Oh, we did watch the first episode of Lemony Snicket's series of unfortunate events, the one with Neil Patrick Harris.
Mm-hmm.
It's very strange. It's pretty. That's another trippy one. And we watched. It's also a family show. It is weird. I don't know. I don't think that Ty was super into it. I gotta say. He hasn't been asking to watch any more than the first after the first episode, but I thought it was pretty good. I also have, how about some Read This Bitches?
Sure.
I finished Lenny Dykstra's House of Nails book because I don't know, he was on Howard Stern and he was pretty weird. I thought it was pretty good. I read it through it very quickly. And if you're into baseball, I think you would probably like it.
Okay,
and even,
so it is a baseball-oriented book? Or?
He talks a lot about baseball and mostly himself as a baseball player and what he thinks you need to do to be a successful baseball player. But he also talks about – it's really a strange book because I don't think I've ever read anything where the guy uses slang that he's just made up. And doesn't tell you what it means. Just assumes that you're gonna know. And you know, you can pick up on it, but it's just weird that he drops it in there. Like he calls cocaine Richards. And he just drops it in there like you would know what Richards is. Given no context whatsoever. But it was, like I said, it was pretty entertaining. And you can hear how he wasted a lot of money and I don't know. He's pretty much a hot mess, but it was entertaining. It's certainly light fare reading. How about some new releases? There's some big ones this week.
Japan happened. Japan just decided to release all their games this week.
Yes.
We're still here, guys. Japan. We make games.
They're trying to distract us from.
They're getting them out now before the tariffs.
Right.
I've been playing Gravity Rush 2.
How's
that's a game that came out for PlayStation 4. You guys have not played any of the Gravity Rush games, right?
No, I think I have the first one, though.
On what?
PlayStation. Wasn't it free on Vita for a while at one point?
So Vita, you have it on.
Yeah, I have a Vita.
I did not realize you had a Vita.
I have a Vita. Wasn't it free, like a PS Plus game? I feel like I have it. Maybe I'm wrong. I could be making that up.
Anyway, how is Gravity Rush 2?
Gravity Rush 2 is... I remember thinking that Cheapy, maybe this you should give it a shot.
Yeah.
Because it was getting good reviews.
Yeah.
You should not give this game a shot.
Oh.
This is not for you at all.
Too hard?
It's odd. It's a little... No, I don't know if it's too hard. The controls are not good, so that makes it a little bit hard.
No, I don't like
that. The camera is also no good. It does this really weird thing where it positions the character. It's a third person action game, but it positions the character like higher up on the screen than most third person games. Like if you look at most third person games, like the back of the person's head that you're looking at is generally towards the middle of the screen.
Uh-huh.
This one has like that head is like almost, I don't know, 2/3 of the way up the screen. So you get like a whole bunch of like screen below your feet.
Why?
For some reason. I don't know. And it could be because you're flying around a lot, but you're not really flying. You're like floating. Hmm. It's very strange.
Upskirts?
How this game
is it upskirts? Is that the reason?
I don't or feet? Think so. They like feet. I haven't really been paying that close of attention, but maybe that's it. Hmm. But it's like really close to being great. It's just, it's similar to my feelings on Last Guardian, really. Like, I really want to like the game, but the camera and the controls, they don't quite work for what the game is doing. There's a lot of, so you hit the right shoulder button, R1, to start floating. And then you aim where you want to go and you hit that again and you'll start floating in that direction. And whatever surface you bump into, that's how you land. And then that's your like new orientation of where your gravity is basically. But it's so frustrating that like, if you're just off a little bit and you land like on the edge perpendicular to where you want to go, then you have to then float up again, kind of reposition yourself and then attack it a second time at a different angle to try to land where you want to. And it's just like little things like that. It's just like, it needs like a snap option or something to like get me where I'm going quickly.
I see.
You know, I know what I want to do. Just make it happen.
You know that I know.
Right. We all know what we want to have happen here. And it is not me landing and going, nope, that's not where I want to be. And then jumping off again and reorienting this camera again and again. And the same thing is like, there's like ground combat that you can do. It's got like a pretty simple combat system and there's upgrades and everything. But a lot of it is just so far. I'm only like 2 hours in, maybe 3 hours in. So maybe I'm just still playing through tutorial type stuff. I don't know. But you'll get caught in these combos, and if you're close to an edge, you'll just fall off the edge. Like, put something there, like, so that this person, obviously, if this was a real person, they're not going to just keep kicking until they fall off the edge. They're going to stop kicking.
Right. Help me out here.
Right. Like, there's no reason why I'm just going to continue kicking off this edge,
right.
And then you got to go float and float back up. And
right.
It's a lot of, like... repeat work. It's very like, it's not friendly to the player.
Got it. Yeah, I don't like that.
Right. I immediately thought of you when I was playing this, going, nope, I hope he didn't buy this because this is not what he wants at all. And all the stories telling through like comic book like panels type of stuff.
Pass. Okay.
I believe you bought something else instead, GP.
I did that face brush.
No, something else.
The keyboard?
No, something else.
Resident Evil 7.
That's the one.
Biohazard.
Yes, Biohazard.
The Siete. Yeah, I did buy that game tape. Yeah, I played about 2 hours of it so far. I'll tell you straight away, I have not tried the virtual reality.
Did you pee your pants yet?
I have not peed my pants yet. I will tell you that I will try the virtual reality for next week's show. I was not prepared to jump into the world of VR this week for whatever reason. I'm trying to put it off as long as possible, basically. I just don't want to put that thing. Yeah, I don't want to hook
the whole thing up. Yeah,
it's not that. It's, you know, honestly, it's not that bad to hook up. That's not even the problem. I don't want to put the thing on my head. It's just weird to put that on there. And, you know, I live in a glass house. And people, if I put this fucking space helmet on during the day,
people are just going to be throwing rocks at you.
They're not going to be, who knows what they'll be doing? I won't be able to see them. They could all be lined up outside my window, like, you know, taking pictures, you know, or, you know, taking selfies while they're mooning me. Who knows? But if I'm home alone, I don't feel comfortable putting on, I don't know. It's weird. you know what they say? If you live in a glass house, don't buy VR, right?
Buy virtual stones.
I don't know. So I'll try for next week's show. But anyway, I played 2 hours of this, and Mrs. Chibi watched me play half an hour. But so far, I'm pretty into it. It is sufficiently scary, but more importantly, like it's, you know, the game is well done and it looks great. They did it sounds great, which is important for, you know, a horror game, obviously. That, you know, the gameplay is, I mean, the combat's not super tight. It doesn't feel like I'm playing Call of Duty. But I know that that's not the intent. They don't want to make you too strong because for whatever reason that's, you know, it just adds more suspense, I guess. But, I like it so far, and I haven't found it too difficult yet, but I don't think I've had to really overcome much in the way of enemies yet. I heard the boss battles are hard. And I am playing on normal. I decided to go to normal.
Oh, I saw so many people say you were right to play on easy.
I know. I saw that after the fact as well.
Can you change the difficulty midstream, or is it one of those games where you can't?
No, you cannot.
I hate that.
It's okay. So far I'm doing okay. I think I can handle it. Someone said I'm a great.
I can't wait for the episode when you say you started over again on easy.
I just remember, like,
that's not going to happen.
No, I'm not starting over again. I told you, like,
yeah, no.
I played one Resident Evil game where I didn't have like the fire extinguisher or something, and I went to like the next disc, and then somehow it let you go through it without having a part, or maybe I'm just stupid and I didn't know what to do. But I played a lot, and then I stopped playing forever. But I did finish 4. That was the last
one. 'Cause 4 is really good.
Yeah. Whoop, Zelda says agrees, I think.
I know, that dog. Poor dog.
Poor old dog.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, she may have pooped.
Great. Poor wombat. Forget the dog.
What's that smell? Yeah. All right. Anyway, you were saying,
so is this related to 5 and 6? I kind of fell off the train. I tried to play some of 5. I didn't play any of 6.
No, this is awesome because it doesn't.
I finished 5 and never touched 6.
I'll tell you story-wise, without any spoilers whatsoever, as far as I know, it has nothing to do with the other ones because I'm not completely baffled by what's going on. I'm actually following 100% the story 2 hours in because it's very simple. It's not, there's no, doesn't mention like a Umbrella Corp or a million other things that just mean nothing to me. It's just, I follow the story. You're a guy looking for his wife, and that's, and weird things are going to happen.
Okay. So it's Silent Hill then.
I mean, I guess that's all that's happened really so far, but it's pretty, like, I'll tell
you.
I'm
sure she's fine.
Yeah, she's not fine. I'll tell you that. Spoiler, she's not fine.
Turns out she was in the supermarket the whole time. Right. And he went on this trip for nothing.
Women be shopping.
You know, she was going to get those 10.
Honey, they had that ice cream. You're like,
They had storks for $10. I had to get it. It's gory as fuck. I'll tell you that right now. Like, it's gross. Like, I was telling Mrs. Chibi, I was whispering to her at dinner because Ty was reading a book, and I was like, you know, telling her some of the stuff that happened, and like gesturing what happened to her. And if you played like the first hour or so, you probably know exactly what I'm talking about, but it's really gross. And I don't know that I've seen something like that in a video game before, type of gross where you're just, yeah. But it's good. I'm looking forward to playing more, not so much in VR, but I guess I'll have to try because I have this fucking thing sitting here. But yeah, so far, two thumbs up for me.
Excellent.
Hmm. What else?
Wombat, you've been playing Tales of Berseria.
Oh yeah, totally. I'm all about it. It's you know, it's much better than Tales of Azeria. But I'm still looking forward to Tales of Seaseria.
Yeah. So does that mean we don't have anything to talk about any other games?
Oh no, I mean that Kingdom Hearts HD 2.8 Final Chapter Prologue.
Wow.
Is a game.
Wow. You know what? I'm not even impressed with the ridiculous title. I guess I am, but the part specifically, I'm impressed with the Roman numerals. Is that right? Is it really?
Yeah.
Roman numerals
2.
Dot 8. Dot regular 8.
So what does that mean? How do you have a final chapter prologue? I'm just confused by that.
Because there's going to be a final chapter, and then there'll be a final chapter epilogue. That makes perfect sense. To explain
everything. I think this game is everything leading up to Kingdom Hearts 3, right?
Is this a remaster?
Yeah, this is up your alley, Wombat.
Okay. I have a backlog of remasters to play.
Mm. You can add this one right on top.
No thanks.
I think this is like 2.8 remasters in one.
Roman numeral 2.
Did you get Yakuza 0?
I want to play Yakuza 0.
I was gonna. So I'm asking. I was being serious. If you got it, because
I'm going to get it. I just it's not a great time right at the moment to be starting that up because I'm still playing through.
Whatever. You're not going to work.
I will be soon, but I'm still playing Final Fantasy 15, and now with Gravity Rush, I don't know how much more Japan I can do at one time.
Zelda agrees.
Mm-hmm.
But Yakuza 0 looks fantastic.
Yeah.
Have you seen some of the goofy stuff in there?
Yes.
The chicken at the bowling alley.
I watched some of the gross stuff that happens during the fights.
The gross stuff?
Yeah, during the fights. Yeah, during the fights. You can really, gotcha. You can like put stuff in people's mouths and then beat them and bad things happen. Yeah, I want to check that out too. But
cool.
Yeah, it does.
The only Yakuza I ever finished was that the zombie one. I can't remember what that's called at the moment. But Yakuza Zombies.
Sure. Any other?
That looks good. Let's see here. For the Wii U, we've got Snowball.
Nope.
On the eShop.
Mm-mm.
Toby the Secret Mind. That one looked okay. I think that came to other things though previously.
So Toby is the secret mind?
I don't know.
They just gave spoiler right in the title.
Toby, the secret mind.
Yeah, I'm going to pass on all those.
Mega Maze? I can't interest you in Mega Maze.
I'm waiting for the Switch version on Mega Maze.
Oh, that's probably a good call there.
Yeah. I don't know how it's going to transfer
Mega Maze
over.
HD. 2.8.
Perfect. Anything else?
No, I think that's enough. Japan can only put out 6 games in a week.
Right.
It's crazy, right? That all these games, like these are the only games coming out this week, and they're all these super Japanese games.
Yeah. I don't know. There must be a reason for it. Maybe something about their financial quarters. I wouldn't be surprised. You know what I'm not surprised about, Wombat?
What?
The quality
Harry's
of
Harry's Razors?
You stepped on my awesome surprise.
Oh.
Or I'm not surprised, rather.
Well, did you know that for decades, big razor companies have continued to increase prices and reap huge profits at the expense of their customers?
Of course I knew that because I put that on the outline. Oh, yeah. I mean, No, I didn't know that.
There were these two ordinary guys, Jeff and Andy, and they were so fed up with getting ripped off, they started Harry's to fix shaving, and they knew that in order to ensure quality, they needed to own their own factory, so they made that happen.
That was a good idea, probably.
It was a better idea than I've ever had.
Let me tell you something. I took a shower today. Now I take my showers like around 5 o'clock. That's like my shower time.
Okay.
And I was particularly hairy on my face because I haven't shaved anything in like maybe 2 weeks. Normally I shave like once a week.
I watched that video of you on the water slide. You're hairy in places more than just your face.
Dude, I want to talk to you about my back hair, but not during a great sponsor spot such as Harry's.
No, that's all right. We'll talk.
You can ask me about it after the Harry spot.
You're like a Chewbacca with an eraser for a head.
I will say that there was like a shadow on me, and it made it look like I was hairier than I actually am. Not to say that I'm not hairy, Harry, I'm all confused now.
Okay. Let's talk about Harry's.
I was saying that I had so much hair that usually I use an electric razor to thin it down a little bit before I shave with the blade, with Harry's blades. I couldn't get through it with the electric razor today. So I had to go straight to the Harry's blade. And it was actually, I realized that there was really no reason to use the electric razor first.
No, Harry's blades are good enough. You don't need to.
I didn't realize that was such a, like a. I just assumed that I would have to, you know, use some some power tools.
Best blades on the market.
Yes,
and they're just $2 a blade compared to the $4 or more you'll pay at the drugstore.
Cheap.
Yeah. So go to harrys.com right now.
Yes.
And enter code CAG at checkout to get a post shave bomb free. That's harrys.com, code CAG. You could also get their shave set for free. You just have to cover shipping when you sign up.
It's beautiful. Yes, that's a good deal. I think that our listeners will really like it. So go to harrys.com and use coupon code CAG. Thank you, Harry's. Now, the question to you, Wombat, is do you want to hear about my back hair? Or do you want to talk about your news and stuff and Overwatch Onslaught?
This is a tough choice.
It's pretty quick. The back hair is pretty quick.
Tell me quickly about your back hair.
So Mrs. Chibi noticed that my back hair was like a swirl. It got like swirly in the middle. You know what I'm saying? Like, I guess with like static electricity.
Like a typhoon of back hair?
Yes, yes, exactly. And that it actually looked like the number 6. And then she realized that if she took a picture of it and then used like one of those apps to make it like 3 in a row, then it looks like the number of the beast.
Yes. And you would, yes. Then did you make the beast with 2 backs?
No.
3. Just, 3 backs.
3 backs.
3 backs.
Yes. 666, Wombat. Yes. Is there a joke that I missed there about 2 backs?
The beast with 2 backs.
Is that what they call it? You know, see,
it's a Shakespearean reference.
Oh, see,
to sex.
I'm very uncouth, Wombat. I wouldn't know that. I just read Lenny Dykstra's book, Wombat.
Sorry. I'll stick with the poop jokes.
Yes, please. So Wombat, you know about the big Overwatch news, right?
Yeah, Chinese New Year.
Yes, you know what they added?
Cocks.
They did. But also, what's a big component of multiplayer games, team-based multiplayer games?
That's right. I saw they added Capture the Flag.
Right, but they called it Capture the Rooster. But it's really a flag.
How is that? So there was no Capture the Flag type mode in this game at all?
Well, so I watched the video that, you know, they put, whenever they make a change in the game, they put out like a 15-minute video with this guy, just like a big head on the screen. And he explains to you why they did that. because he knows people will go crazy if they don't do that. So they explain that they owe, from the very start, they wanted to have capture the flag, but they didn't.
Revolutionary.
Nope. They didn't think it worked with this hero-based format where you have these
guys. You put a flag over there and one team tries to get it and bring it back.
Yes, but they didn't think it was going to work right because they thought
you're missing the nuances and depth of Overwatch, Shipwreck.
Yes.
We don't know if these characters can grab a flag. Let's give them a rooster.
No. It's really a flag. It's just a flag with a rooster on it.
It's not even a rooster.
No, just a flag.
What the?
I'm so glad that I play Overwatch because somebody in this group has to be in touch with popular culture and be able to appreciate these dank memes. So
have you stopped the rooster yet?
I did play one round of Capture the Rooster, and it was a draw. So I didn't get my free loot box. But I did get from my free loot box.
Is there an Alice in Chains tie in here? What's this rooster thing?
I made the joke. You missed it.
No, it wasn't. I think your lyrics were off.
No, I said to just stop the rooster. Because they come to stop the rooster.
Oh, yeah, I guess he ain't going to die.
Another wombat joke over my head.
That's okay. Everyone likes Alice.
Anyway, there's all new skins. I got the awesome May skin, or at least I think there's maybe Megas more than one skin, but I got the red looking one, which is pretty good. And did you see about the controversy about May? you don't even care.
No, I don't know, nor do I really.
She's not
care.
Lesbian enough.
close. Keep going.
She's too lesbian?
No.
She's not lesbian.
It's not lesbian. It's not about her sexual orientation.
She wears glasses now.
She always wore glasses. So people,
she put on a little weight.
Close. You're so close.
Her boobs got smaller.
No, you're so close.
Her boobs got bigger.
No. Oh, you're so close. It's amazing. You just know the internet. Shipwreck is just tapped in. you want to try? I mean, you're so close. You're like, you're running out of body parts.
Is it butt stuff?
Well, her waist.
No, they accidentally made her look thinner.
Right. Her waist got smaller. Her waist. You were there.
Yeah.
So her waist, they said there was a glitch or something and her waist got smaller. But people noticed. Like I looked at the picture, honestly, like I couldn't tell the difference. But, you know, I was looking at my phone maybe, and also I'm old. But that's the thing with her. Like, people like that she's thick. You know, that she's not your typical skinny.
It really, to me, it looks like it's just the coat.
Well, that's the thing. She's also, like, you don't really know. But, like, you can see, like, on some of her outfits, you can see her legs. And they're, you know, it's not the typical video game model. They're not using that. And that's why people like Overwatch. So people were worried that she wasn't thick anymore. But don't worry.
How is she going to be able to carry that flag without all this extra thickness in her waist? Is that what they were worried about?
No. So do you want to know what I told you they were worried about the balancing and stuff. So
her waist got too small?
No. About like the character. So they were going to make rules. Like
back pain.
They were worried that it would be too easy. Like if a character, some characters can fly, some can jump really far. It'd be too easy to cap the flag. But the big gameplay tweak that they made was when you capture the flag, you can't just grab it. You have to camp on it for a few seconds. That was the big concession or innovation.
That innovation. Let's patent that one.
Concessivation? I don't know.
Great. I hope you capture many flags.
It's not, let me put it this way, it's not tribes. But whatever. It's for more free content
That's great.
A great game.
I want them to keep supporting this game that people
It's
love,
crazy. I mean, all
Let's
free.
Not call adding Capture the Flag a watershed moment
no,
in video games.
It's absolutely not. But the skins are, people really like the skins. And, you know, it's cool. You're celebrating, you know, Chinese culture. It's great. Whee! With cocks. Everybody wins. What else we have here in Wombat's news and stuff and Overwatch Onslaught?
What do we want to talk about next?
Why don't you just tell me what you want to talk about next?
The Warner Brothers thing. That's kind of interesting.
That's actually really interesting. The fact that, for those who don't know, Avalanche Studios, software game developer who made such classic games as Disney Infinity and Toy Story 3, which actually is a great game if you never played that, they are now making a Cars game, Disney's Cars, for Warner Brothers, which is weird in so many ways.
Well, they've made this. They've made the Cars game before, right?
Yeah, they made the last Cars game, which was all right.
That was like the Battle Racer or something, sort of.
Yeah. What's really interesting about this is obviously Warner Brothers is DC Comics and Disney is Marvel. So the fact that they're working on something together is sort of interesting in itself, even if it is two different branches. But also Warner Brothers makes Lego Dimensions. Avalanche has a lot of experience in the Toys to Life realm. Would Avalanche be making Disney, because they do have Lego Disney stuff, is that something that we could possibly see in Lego Dimensions? That's the speculation that people want to make.
That's
I don't think it would ever happen.
There.
I don't think it would ever happen
at all.
Huh?
I don't understand how that has to do with Avalanche, really. Like,
well, Avalanche could develop Disney Lego games.
They're Lego figures. They already have that game developed. It's just putting Disney skins on them. That's been a rumor since. The Lego rumor's been around ever since Disney Infinity got shut down. Everybody's like, they can make Lego Disney figures now.
Or maybe they would just make a standalone Lego Disney game without the figures, but which actually I would love that.
Right, no more figures, right?
That would probably be a day one purchase if they actually made a Lego Disney.
So were Lego there details game. On, like, I don't understand the timing of this. Like, hasn't Avalanche been closed for a while?
Yeah.
I don't know if they
ever. What are these people doing? Were they still, like, loyal to Avalanche? Just sitting around
waiting? They may have known this was coming, and, you know, the rumors of their demise may have been. It may have all been smoke and mirrors. Like, oh, yeah, we're closed now. But really, they weren't. I don't know. We don't know how long they've been working on this game for. I mean, if it's supposed to come out, I would assume this summer to coincide with the movie release.
Okay, well, it says, this is so weird. Like, so Disney closed Avalanche in May. And then Warner Brothers, it says, managed to rehire many of the team.
It could have, we don't know. It could have been within like a month. And then it may just have been an NDA until now.
I mean, it certainly could have. I just, the timing is weird.
Oh, yeah, no, it's definitely weird, but I'm not saying you're wrong.
They could just be updating, you know, the Cars 2 game, you know?
Well, there's a new Cars movie coming out, so I'm sure it's going to be all.
Yeah, I'm saying they could just take that.
New characters.
They could probably throw together the Cars 3 game pretty quickly. Just take the Cars 2 game, put in the new characters.
This game industry biz article you linked to?
Yeah.
They spell Mortal Kombat with a C. How do you do that?
Well, then there goes that. Let's not even talk about this anymore.
I know. I just don't understand that.
Nope,
like, you're
that's
like,
it. It's too late.
Warner Brothers, known for their Lego series, Lord of the Rings, Batman, and Mortal Kombat. And you really, like, you can't make sure that spell check doesn't correct Mortal Kombat on you?
Maybe he just had a kid and he's running on.
That's fine.
Interrupted
I'm
sleep.
Sorry. I'm sorry, senior editor Christopher Dring. I'm sure you know that Mortal Kombat spelled with a K.
Yes, he does. He knows. What else we got here?
I've been playing that new Call of Duty game that came out this year. Last year, I guess, at this point.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I've heard that's okay.
November.
It's really good, that single player. I don't know why it got such lousy reviews, but, you know, whatever.
I don't either.
It's fantastic. It's
yeah.
Did you finish?
It's their second best single player ever, right? Might be my favorite one.
I right now I think I give the edge to Titanfall 2 slightly, but
no, I'm talking about Call of Duty.
Huh?
I'm talking about Call
of
Duty.
Just overall. I thought you meant of last year.
No, I'm just talking about the Call of Duty series in general. Like this is number 2, I would say, on the campaign.
What's number 1?
Black Ops.
Oh, okay. Sure. Yeah. I mean, it's really good. It's very unique with the setting in basically outer space. The ship-to-ship combat stuff is really well done. Piloting those ships and the dogfighting is really intuitive. It works really well. I think it's probably a misstep to not have multiplayer dogfighting. I think you brought that up, Cheapy, maybe? At some point? I don't know. It would be something cool for them to have. I don't believe it's there, unless I'm just missing it. And but the new weapons are really cool. Like all different, you know. Huh?
They are. They're the homing grenades and stuff or whatever.
Yeah, or just, you know, just the different ways to, like, a gun with more than one sight configuration at the push of the D-pad.
Yeah.
Is a really cool idea that, you know, like, oh, this is a... You want a submachine gun and a shotgun, and you also want your assault rifle, but you can only carry two weapons? Well, this gun is both. It's a submachine gun, then you push the button, and now it's a shotgun. Like, okay, cool, I'll take that one with me. So, no, it's cool. It's got a lot of cool stuff going on. I like the little side mission thing with the map. So, yeah, I'm probably very close to the end. I've done all the side missions, which...
It's short.
You know, yeah, if you... You know, and you get certain achievements now on the Xbox, because I know you guys didn't play this game on the Xbox. When you get certain achievements,
on the home of Call of Duty.
The new home of Call of Duty.
Where Call of Duty lives, where it goes home after a long day's work.
When you get certain achievements that not a lot of people have gotten, like on the planet, it shows up with a little diamond and it plays a little chime to show that you got a rare achievement.
Oh.
And I did all of the little side missions. I got the little chime.
Nice.
6% of people.
Wow.
6% of people have done those side missions. And I'm surprised. I'm like, it just surprised me.
Well,
that,
a lot of people don't touch the story.
Yeah, I know. And I think that's probably why their reviews are so bad. I'm like, they made a really good single player game. And I know that there seem to be a lot of issues with the multiplayer. And it's so interesting how much that's hurt their perspective of this game. But I guess not, because it's Call of Duty and that's what it's all about.
Yeah. Well, people didn't like the microtransactions.
Yeah, stuff. That's what I'm saying. There's a lot of microtransactions virtual currency in the multiplayer. Stuff. Yeah. Same thing even in zombie mode. I think they added it, which is sort of weird. I played a little of the single player of that. It's a cute idea, the single player. Did you try the zombie mode at all, either one of you?
I'm going to.
I played split screen.
Yeah. I liked the little movie they show before it.
Ooh,
a cartoon.
I could play that with Ty, maybe. Is that appropriate or no?
I let Sabrina check it out like one round.
Yeah.
And I asked her if she wanted to play it with me and she goes, "No, that's gross." And that was it.
Yeah.
That conversation.
That's going to give Ty nightmares. I'm going to pass on that.
Yeah. I knew it wouldn't be enough to give Sabrina nightmares, but it was definitely enough for her to be like, "No, that's gross." So there goes that.
We'll
stick with Lovers in a Dangerous Space.
Yeah, that's a fun one. Holy
shit. That's a fun one. It's going to be free next month. So if you're looking for a good co-op game to play with your kids or loved one,
yep,
Lovers in a Dangerous Space Time is actually amazing for that.
Not as good as Overcooked, but it's still good. And
I don't have that game, though, so I can't.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you buy the Super Pack? It comes with everything now. Now's your chance.
I don't know.
It's so good. It's so good. You can yell at your family. Oh, man. Our family was doing some good yelling the other night. I'll tell you that. I was like, I thought for a moment that I should record it, but then I decided against it. But it was quality. there was a yelling. That game is fun. One day I will have people who are skilled at it, and we will play together, and all will be right in the world. I've been playing the remaster, the Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remaster, because a CAG sent it to me. I don't know if he wants me to say his name, so I won't. Or maybe I'll say it next week. But anyway, it's it's awesome.
Is it good?
It's so good. And then
because I got the remaster pack, the whole
thing, oh good,
which I paid for with my own money.
Nice. Yeah. Sorry, I don't know what that's like. I'm sorry. It just rains games on me left and right. It looks. I mean, it uses the same engine as the Infinite Warfare, so it looks so good. And you know,
really, it does. It looks good. It looks perfect. Downloaded all 78 gigabytes of hard drive space to download that game. I'm gonna play it.
And you know, I'm playing on the Pro, so I'm getting those Pro.
Yes, I'm sure it looks a little better for you than it will for me.
I mean, it doesn't. I would say that it's not. I mean, I thought that the Infinite Warfare single player was stunning looking. Like, I was constantly trying to get Mrs. Cheapy to look at it and get her to be interested in it because I just said, wow, so many times. This is not quite at that level, but it is fun to go back and play the old game and have it look pretty awesome.
You know, it's funny. Elliot likes to sit on the couch and watch my ship. The spaceship take off from the hangar.
Whoa, what game? Call of Duty. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
It just blows his mind every time.
Well, you know,
he asks, can I watch the spaceship take off? I'm like, sure.
You know, it would really blow his mind? The VR version. They have the free, you know, mini game.
I think at 5 years old, he might be too young for that.
They say 12 and up, 12 and up, or over 12. Actually,
yeah, he's not over 12.
I know, but it's probably okay for like a minute. But you basically you launch the ship, you know, in VR. It's pretty.
I'm sure it's very cool.
Yeah, I'm never playing it again. What else? Funko retro.
Are we all gonna get all the retro mini Funko, the Funko mystery minis? Are we getting all of them?
They look pretty fantastic.
Are they blind boxes or?
They're blind boxes, yeah. So they had this toy fair in London, I guess, that these got announced at. And Funko, of course, does all those pop figures where everything looks the same. Wombat buys 8 Vault Boys. They have the same exact head.
I have. How many pop vinyls and how many mystery minis do we think are on my desk right now?
50.
50? I think you might be overestimating a little bit.
67.
No.
4.
You're no fun.
4.
I'm going to go with 18.
18. There are 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 Funko Pop vinyls. Those are the big ones.
Are they in the box?
And, huh? Three of them are not in the box. So 6 are out. 6 in the box, 3 out of the box. And as far as mystery minis on my desk go, I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 10. So I guess that would be it's too many. Yeah. Total of 19. So Shipwreck was pretty close with his 18.
I'm going to buy these.
These look fantastic. Because they're not Funko Pops. They actually made them shapes.
Right.
Yeah.
They look good.
Well, the minis they do are a whole different ball of cheese.
Sure. Frogger has his tie and his briefcase.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Hubert, like,
they still can't quite get Hubert right.
I think it's the feet. He's got like his feet are too human. And it looks weird.
No, Too Human was a different game. It wouldn't be in this.
Love that game. I would buy some Too Human figures if they threw them in here.
Yeah, they're good. Yeah.
But yeah, it looks so good. Like, I just have a feeling I'm gonna buy a whole like package of these.
What's the snake's name again?
The coil guy?
Yeah. Is it Coily?
Something like that. I don't remember.
Snakey.
Sure. But the Dig Dug figures are great. Those Dig Dug ones are great.
Yes.
Yes,
the Dig Dug. I don't care about the centipede ones so much.
I like the centipede. I don't care about the Pac-Man ghosts. Miss Pac-Man is pretty fresh though.
Yeah, yeah. The purple, what's going on with that purple ghost? Like, that's the one that stands out, like, I don't know, like, that doesn't really look.
And the
really
snake's name
good.
Is Coily. I was right.
Yes. Yeah, those are cool. All right, I'm getting those.
Yeah, or I guess it's Pinky? Is that
might
Pinky?
Be Pinky. It might be Pink. It may just be a bad picture. Because those don't look like the final pops.
And there's a Mega Man in there as well?
Is there a Mega Man? Where? Hold on, oh, yeah, look at that. Right, there's a Mega
right
Man.
Right there on the package.
Alexa, yeah, stop.
No, you're right. You're right.
Fucker. Jesus. She's like reading me the news. Fuck. I'm trying to do a show here, Alexa.
Oh, I didn't know who you were. I thought you were yelling at your wife for a second.
Oh, wow. Sorry. No.
I've never heard you talk to your wife that way before.
No.
You sound like me.
I sound like you. You talk to your wife that way? Oh, shit. Look at you.
Shut up, woman.
Where are we here? Nintendo.
Mm-hmm.
Did we talk about all this shit already?
We talked about all this. Yeah, we talked about all this.
Good. Perfect.
I think we talked about pretty much everything else.
Here, one question from Nintendo from at Hired Geek MN says, with all the attention on the Switch, how does Microsoft and Sony get the focus back on them?
Scorpio.
Right. We can lead right into our Scorpio talk. Yes. I mean, that's,
and also, you know, good games like Mass Effect.
Right.
And also, it doesn't matter because people buy PlayStation 4s. No matter what.
Right. They've sold a lot already. They're good to go at this point.
They're going
to
keep on selling those.
Right. If nobody bought anymore, they would still be good to go. But that's not going to happen.
Scorpio.
Yeah. So Scorpio, there was two little bits of Scorpio news. One really just the one important one is that Digital Foundry got a hold of the spec sheet, the white sheet on the Scorpio. And overall, they seem pretty impressed with it, but they did say that they're going to wind up using like this checkerboarding and not really being native 4K for some games. So it's really may not be the true native 4K machine that Microsoft has been touting, but they did seem pretty impressed overall by what had leaked out. When is this coming out? Is this going to be like announced at E3?
This like the Switch doesn't really exist yet.
Or revealed at E3 rather, and then out for the holiday season. Is that what we're thinking? Does that make sense?
Sure, why not?
I guess the other bit of Scorpio news was that the developer of Oni and the Blind Forest, is that a game name?
Ori.
I said Oni.
Yeah. Oni is a Bungie game, isn't it?
Yes. Yep. And it means devil in Japanese.
I thought it meant your mom.
he said that basically he was writing on Gaff, and he said that he really thought that now that we're all using PC architecture, that going forward all console games are going to be backwards compatible, and that the Scorpio is really Microsoft's next gen Xbox, but you know, because you know, power wise it is, but because it's fully backwards compatible, it's not, you know, like 100% backwards compatible. I don't know. It's sort of like a tricky thing. Like, how do you market that as Microsoft? How do you position this? If it really is powerful enough to be a next gen system, you know, how do you sell this to the customer now, and you're not calling it the next gen? You can't, because
no, they're not. They're apparently not going to release any games for it that are only playable on it.
Right?
No, they definitely will.
They said they're not.
They definitely.
They've
will.
Said it many times. You're not allowed.
Or
to make...
Is that sort of like? Do they just kind of like phase it in? Like you're going to ease you into the next generation?
That could be.
There's going to be an easing process here, I'm sure, because it just doesn't make sense to have this thing be so much more powerful than the Xbox One.
Right.
And not take advantage of it.
Because what you can do is, now you're just going again on the old cycle. You got like, you can have Scorpio Slim or whatever, you know, who knows? The question is like, what do they call this thing? Are they going to call it, is it going to be like Xbox One something? Is it going to be a whole new something else? I mean, the marketing is pretty tricky, I feel. And I don't know that I'm willing to put in the time to think about like what they should be doing. But I don't know. Don't you agree that this is like, it's like a slippery slope here? You're going to put this thing out. They're probably going to charge. How much are they going to charge for it? They're going to charge. Well, we talked about this before.
$400.
Yeah, it's $400.
That's the price.
You think it's like $600 cheaper.
Well, I guess if it's coming out by Christmas, it's probably not going to be $600. I don't know. We got to see what all, I mean, the Xbox.
I think right now we're still in the way too much speculation phase. And until we see something, it's just, we're just spitting in the wind, as they
say. I will say one last thing that I did not expect to see: Xbox One S's and regular Xbox One so cheap as they are now. I mean, and they have been for the last few months now, I guess. I mean, like crazy, like super cheap. So I don't know. It would seem weird to put out a $600 console now when you're selling whatever the current hotness for two, you know, not even $250. So, hey, we'll have to wait and see. But it is interesting. What else we got here? Anyone have any problems with their Xbox Elite controllers?
I don't have one.
Well, that's a problem. Ship?
Mine's fine still.
Okay. Because at Jack,
I generally have never had any problems with controllers.
Xbox controllers?
Any controllers. I've never had one really die on me.
The Y button sticks on my day one controller. Drives me bananas.
You've got very soft hands, Shipwreck.
I just take care of my stuff, I think.
Maybe.
And I'm lucky.
While we're talking about Microsoft, at Curbstomped asks, since Microsoft canceled Scalebound and Fable Legend, is Sea of Thieves up next? I think that this game looks pretty good and people seem excited about it. So, and it seems
and
like
it doesn't. It may not be that expensive either.
Oh, to develop?
Yeah.
It's probably, they're funding that whole studio. So it's probably not that cheap. But I think it has a pretty good upside with, you know, my in-game purchases, I think. You know, you can imagine all the customization options that they could offer for like everybody's pirate ship and pirate character, and you know, they could sell you a million different ways.
This thing needs to come out things. Though, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Like it needs it.
This is going to be
that's
a big
the only worry about it is that it was playable at E3, and I don't know, it looked like it was probably pretty close to being ready. I don't know.
There's been a closed beta, I know. I'm pretty sure there was a closed beta. And I think this will be probably a big focus for Microsoft at E3 this year. And it's probably a holiday season game, right?
Yeah. I think the difference between it and Scalebound and Fable Legends, first of all, anybody that played Fable Legends, they came away thinking this is not very good.
I played Fable Legends. It was not very good.
You didn't even have to play it to
right. You could look at it and go, "This is not what we want."
No.
And Scalebound, there were just so like we never played it. It was in development. They showed it for a long time, but it was never playable at any of the events. Right. It doesn't really have a huge upside.
Right.
It's not, Sea of Thieves is not the same as those other two.
At some point they did the math and they realized they're not making their money back on Scalebound. Just shut it down. Sea of Thieves, I think, whether or not it's going to be like a great game or not, you could see people sinking money into it after their initial $60 purchase, right? Just pirates.
Is it
like a free-to-play game?
Does it have Capture the Flag?
They have a lot of flags, I think, in that game.
I mean, it's definitely a high concept game, but maybe that's why they're going to release it. Who knows?
I feel like it could make money. It can get people hooked on the type of game people get hooked into it, and with their little pirate posses. They probably don't call them pirate posses. What do you call like a pirate, a group of pirates? What would you call that?
Cocks.
Group of cocks? Mm-hmm. A bunch of cocks, rather. All right.
I believe it's a cock of pirates.
A cock of pirates.
Fable, man, that makes me sad. Just looking at Fable and remembering
how good Fable 2 was, yeah, and how bad Fable 3 was by comparison.
Right, I remember that.
Boy, did they shit the bed on that franchise.
It was It's such a huge potential franchise. And
oh, it should be as big as any franchise.
As big as Skyrim.
Yeah, it should be
a single platform.
It legitimately
Skyrim.
Should be. Yeah, Fable 1 was very good. It was flawed, but it was a very good game. It was if the over promises weren't made, everyone's feelings on Fable would be much different. And Fable 2 was great. Fable 3 was rushed, and you know it was obvious. And then they just never made another one. It's very strange. That whole situation was weird.
Why don't they make another one? Maybe they'll make another one. Maybe they're making one right now.
Who?
Somebody. Who? Secret.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You don't know.
Yeah.
You're right, though. It should be a big success for them. Continued success. There's no reason for that franchise to go under. They sold copies. It moved. It put asses in seats, that game. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go to bed. How about that? Who wants to do that?
I would
Shipwreck,
love to do
you
that.
Going to sleep?
Let's do that. Let's remind everybody to follow us on Twitter at GBD, at New Wombat, at Shipwreck, at Video Game Deals. Thorbond's going to be at PAX South this weekend. I think it's this weekend, right? So check that out. And don't forget to go to harrys.com and use coupon code KEG at checkout to get a post-shave bomb. Also, and your free trial set. harrys.com, coupon code KEG. And did you do another uninformed opinions this week, Wombat, or what?
No, unfortunately.
Shit.
Not my fault.
All right, so fans of Zelda will not be able to hear her anywhere else but here.
There you go.
It's an exclusive, KEGcast exclusive. All right. See you next week.
Bread's done.
What if every choice you made changed the way you look and how people see you? Would you shun evil and lead a life of virtue? Become a righteous hero? Decide your destiny. Fable, for every choice, a consequence. Rated M for mature.